President Obama says he wants to give America a raise.
From $7.25 an hour to $10.10 an hour.
White House officials claim raising the minimum wage could help 28 million people.
Can I get like a large one to go?
Sure.
But the nonpartisan Congressional Budget Office sees it differently. It shows that it could lift up to 900,000 people out of poverty, but it could also cost us between half a million and a million jobs.
It's not out of spite that an owner would decide to go to a, let's say, a different business model if costs went up, but it would really be out of necessity.
Michael Saltzman is with the Employment Policies Institute, a Washington think tank that focuses on entry-level jobs. They recently released this commercial.
What happens if we raise the minimum wage?
I see a lot of people losing their jobs.
Really? I don't see it in there.
No, it's right here in the Congressional Budget Office report.
One concern for many Americans is how an increased minimum wage will impact them as consumers. For some sectors, it will mean raising prices to pay for those extra labor costs. In others, it will mean a changed experience, whether you're paying a toll, shopping, or dining out.
If you're a grocery store, it might mean going to the self-checkout lanes that are now ubiquitous. You know, if you're a restaurant, it could mean going towards a tablet-type ordering device instead of having servers take people's order.
Small business owner Mondell Powell says raising the minimum wage could hurt at first, but he's hopeful in the long term.
In the long run, those individuals being able to participate in the consumer process helps everyone, especially small businesses.
Mark Clark, a professor of business management, says there can be a middle ground, making the decision a regional one.
It's much more expensive to live in San Francisco, Washington, D.C., or L.A. than it is to live in some places in the heart of America. And so a minimum wage at the federal level is sort of a blunt instrument, and it doesn't capture the nuance of what you might need from state to state.
In Washington, I'm Christine Frizzell reporting.